Hey, what's going on, good people? Appreciate you for checking back in. Today, we're going to talk about self-care. Hey, what's going on, good people? It's your boy, James Harris, founder of a movement called Men to Heal, which focuses on men's overall wellness, our mental health, as well as our physical health. And I'm also the author of a book called Man, Just Express Yourself. Pretty much, you can get that at Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Target, Walmart, pretty much anywhere books are sold. I definitely appreciate you guys for purchasing that time at the time. Coming up on that anniversary, I'm so excited. Special thanks, of course, to the fellow therapists who got this in our lobby and do it for interventions or a conversation starter within sessions. Of course, appreciate the parents who got this book for their teens, sons, their boys, so they can grow with this too. And of course, the wives and partners who got this book for their male loved one, their husband or their fiance or boyfriend. Highlighting those tools so they can discuss over date night and dinner. I definitely appreciate hearing your stories. Continue to send them in my inbox or email or message, however you need to do that. I definitely appreciate you. Thanks for the support on the channel as well. Make sure you like, share, subscribe. Definitely appreciate all that love. So when we talk about self-care, it is essential, you know, that we take back time for ourselves. Pretty much being mindful, taking time to pay attention to you directly. It's not selfish. I know a lot of people have that difficult twofold, myself included, of not so much neglecting myself, but tend to put others before me and my personal needs. So I've definitely extended my boundaries and enforced my boundaries now. But pretty much how do you take care of yourself in order to avoid burnout and compassion fatigue is self-care. That's the remedy. So you got to increase your self-care, whether you're doing it on self-care Sundays or just love things throughout the day. Incorporate self-care every day helps you to serve a more, you know, it's like armor to protect you, you know, your energy levels in order to survive and thrive on a day-to-day. If you practice self-care on the regular, things wouldn't bother you as much in certain spaces, whether that's work, whether that's in your relationships or with your coworkers or teammates and stuff like that. Self-care goes a long way in managing stress and living your best life. Your full potential can be reached by doing different things day-to-day as far as self-care. Self-care, again, means taking time to love yourself. A lot of people don't do that often, or they do it in a way that tend to be associated with reckless behavior, like those negative coping mechanisms and stuff like that, substance use. But it's some positive things that you can do to uplift yourself and esteem yourself. Appreciate that there's only one you. You're the expert on yourself. And it's beneficial if you do that. So self-care definitely means understanding and knowing how to decompress after a long day of work. I know a lot of people like go to work, go to a second job, or go to work, come home, hang with the kids, hang with the partner, and do some more work stuff. Figure out how to tune it off. Leave work at work. Self-care means feeding your spiritual self. So identify whatever your spiritual beliefs are and feed those things, whether it's meditation, whether it's praying, whether it's doing something to connect you with your higher power. Self-care also means knowing how to decompress, again, like in that moment. So be in that moment. Self-care means taking time to get to know you better. That's a benefiting one. I can't like stress that enough, because we oftentimes feel that we know ourselves, but we don't know ourselves because we've neglected ourselves for so long. Identify what you like to do and pretty much enjoy it. I know it's the COVID thing phasing off, so you definitely can get out there and start exercising, walking, mingling with people, of course, respecting distance and the guidelines and stuff like that. Make sure that you're well-fed, not just from a nutritional standpoint, but from a mindset standpoint. Be careful what you're ingesting as far as media, as far as different content and stuff like that. Proper night's sleep is also a part of self-care. So, of course, you probably can't get the recommended 8 hours, but get as much as you can without it being interrupted. Like, if you have difficulty staying asleep or falling asleep, you want to make the necessary adjustments to, you know, try to put your mind at ease, try to be in a better position. You also want to know your limits, your boundaries, and your expectations. That's part of self-care as well, because you having the ability to say no will assist you in your growth, will assist you in other people recognizing the fact that, oh, they're working on themselves. Again, it'll help you do those things. So appreciate you. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I didn't want to draw it all out because I want you to do your own research. I want you to do your own things to conduct information on what self-care is. So check me on the next one.